Okay, so this video is going to focus on a word problem dealing with rational expressions, specifically talking about a boat going upstream, downstream, going against the current, with the current, that kind of thing. So in order to do this problem, we are going to need a couple different pieces for it. We are going to be talking about the distance formula and looking on how it's going to impact going upstream and downstream. This video was recommended by someone specifically to do. So always do remember, if there is a specific math question or a specific problem that you're struggling with that I don't have a video for, always comment down below and let me know what that problem is, and I will be more than happy to create a video to help you out with that idea. So let's go ahead and read through this problem so we see specifically what kind of problem we're talking about here. So this problem says that we have, so it says the speed of a boat in still water is 15 miles per hour. If the boat travels 8 miles downstream in the same time that it takes it to travel 4 miles upstream, what is the speed of the current here? All right, so we have a boat that's sitting in still water. The fact that it's sitting in still water, honestly, that's not a huge component to the problem. If anything else, I think it's probably there more to confuse you, to think, well, that still water is, how's that gonna impact my equation? That's gotta make a difference on it. But honestly, not really. If you're familiar with any of these kind of problems, the setup of this problem is still exactly the same. So we have a boat that's sitting in still water. But then it says, well, the boat's going 15 miles per hour. So it's using its motor or whatever it is to go 15 miles an hour. So if it goes 8 miles downstream, so it says it can go 8 miles downstream. So with the current, it can go 8 miles downstream in the same time that it would take it to go 4 miles upstream. So obviously it could go longer downstream than it can upstream, right? Downstream, you're going with the current, you know, you're flowing with the water. When you're going upstream, you're fighting against the current, so it's gonna be harder for you. So what we're gonna need to do in order to solve this problem, first off, is we're going to need to know the distance formula. So the distance formula looks like this. It says distance is equal to rate times time. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna create a formula for both situations. We're gonna create a formula for when we're going downstream and then another formula for when we're going upstream. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna take those two equations and set them equal to each other for us to solve. So let's first focus on the downstream one. So we need to plug in distance, a rate, and a time as much as we can here. So it gives us the distance. It says 8 miles going downstream. So I'm going to plug in an 8 for the distance. The rate is the speed. So it says it's going 15 miles per hour. So for the rate, I'm going to plug in 15. But the other component that you need to add to this is the fact that it's going downstream, it's going with the current, that's going to give it a little push, a little bit of nudge in its speed, which is why I was able to go a longer distance. So we're going to say 15 miles per hour plus X, and that's going to represent 15 miles an hour plus the help of the current. And then we're gonna multiply it times t. We don't have anything here that specifies anything with time. It just says it takes the same time to go 8 miles downstream as the same time to go 4 miles upstream. Doesn't actually specifically say what kind of time we're talking about. So time is just gonna stay time. And we're gonna do the exact same thing here, but we're gonna do it for when we're going upstream. So let's plug and chug into that as well. So for going upstream, it says 4 miles, so I'm gonna plug in a 4 for D. And the rate here is still 15 miles an hour, so for the rate, I'm gonna plug in 15, but because we're going upstream, we're fighting the current, we're gonna lose a little bit of our speed on that. So we're gonna say 15 minus X for that situation. And then we're still gonna tack on T. We still don't know anything about time, so that's gonna stay the same. Now, in order to take these two equations and kind of merge them together, we need them to be solved for the same thing. And looking at these equations here, the only variables we have are x and t. Well, it's going to be easier for us to solve for T in both of them. So that needs to be our next step here. After we initially plug it into the distance formula here, we need to go ahead and solve both equations for T so that we can then merge the equations together, set them equal to each other, and solve. So starting with the equation on the left, if I'm solving that for T, all I have to do is divide by the 15 plus X, on both sides. So 15 plus X cancels with 15 plus X, and T is equal to 8 over 15 plus X. Solving the equation on the right for T, so here I would just be dividing by 15 minus X on both sides, so that 15 minus X is going to cancel, and I'm left with T is equal to 4 over 15 minus X. What this is going to do here, I have both equations solved for T, so technically T equals T, right? So I can go ahead and take this X 8 over 15 plus X, and I can plug it in for T over here. All right, so essentially that would look like this. 4 over 15 minus X is equal to 8 over 15 plus X. And this is the equation that we're going to want to solve. So over here, I'm just going to rewrite that equation. All right, so we're going to solve this thing here. So for this particular equation here, there's a couple of different ways that we can look at solving this equation here. We can either multiply the entire equation by the lowest common denominator. Another way that we can look at it is the fact that this is set up as a proportion, and we could also cross multiply. That tends to be the way that I prefer to solve these here when it's in this specific setup here. Remember that we can cross multiply anytime we have two ratios, two fractions set equal to each other, it gives us a proportion, and we can solve any proportion by cross multiplying. So that's how I'm going to do this one here. So if I cross multiply, that means I'm going to take 4 times 15 plus x. So 4 times 15 plus x, and that's going to equal 8 times the 15 minus x. Okay, so that's how you cross multiply in solving a proportion. After I cross multiply, this is just a matter of using my solving equation steps to simplify down this equation and solve for x, starting with distributing. We have two cases of the distributive property. On the left-hand side, we have to distribute by 4. So 4 times 15 is going to give me 60, plus 4 times x is 4 times x. On the right-hand side, 8 times 15 is 120, minus 8 times x is 8 times x. After we've simplified, we do not have any like terms, so our next step is to isolate the variable. Get your x on one side, get your number on the other side. I'm going to move my x to the left-hand side. Because this is a negative 8x, I can do the opposite and add 8x to both sides. That's going to give me, if I drop down 60, 4x plus 8x is 12x, and that's going to equal 120. And since I chose to get x alone on the, or since I'm choosing to get x on the left-hand side, that means I want my numbers to go to the right-hand side. Since this is a positive 60, I'm going to subtract 60 on both sides. So that it'll cancel on the left. I can drop down 12x. And on the right-hand side, 120 minus 60 is 60. Last step here, we have 12x. Remember, that is 12 times x. So the opposite of multiplication is division. So I'm going to divide both sides by 12, and I'm left that x is equal to 5. Going back up to the question, it asks us to solve what is the speed of the current. So that just means the current is 5 miles per hour, which essentially almost, when you think about it, it says that the water is still, so technically it shouldn't be moving, but we've just solved and figured out that it's going at 5 miles per hour, so it's a tiny bit contradictory here, but again, that's why I said adding in the still water component here, it's almost just kind of meant there to confuse you, to get you to second guess yourself. Unfortunately, a lot of math problems are like that. I don't know why. They really want to test your skills and your knowledge to see if you know what you're really talking about. But otherwise here, so again, we need to plug in for the distance formula twice so that we can solve each one of these for t, so that we can then create our big equation over here that we can solve in order to find that current. So here, x is 5, so x is, the current is 5 miles per hour.